A lot of news to get to this morning as the Delta variant surges. ABC News confirming that the FDA is expected to authorize a third booster shot for immunocompromised people just a few hours from now.
This comes as hospitals across the country reach their breaking point. Take a look at this. The University of Mississippi Medical Center converting a parking garage into a field hospital for extra space. The state reporting more than 3,000 positive cases on Wednesday.
We'll hear from Dr. Fauci in a moment, but first we'll begin with Victor Oquendo in Gainesville, Florida, with the latest. Good morning, Victor.
Good morning, Michael. The FDA is expected to give the green light on a third shot, but here at UF Health Chan's Hospital, where 92% of their COVID patients are not vaccinated, they're still pushing people to get their first shot. One nurse from a packed ICU telling me that what they saw last year now feels like a warm-up.
This morning, ABC News confirming the FDA is expected to authorize a third booster shot for immunocompromised people today. The CDC advisory panel then set to meet Friday. Director Walensky could greenlight the shots soon after. The news coming as the CDC confirms more than a million people have already reported getting a third shot, even without FDA authorization. Eric Astakan, a flight attendant, is participating in UC Davis's booster trial.
Working as a flight attendant, I'm exposed to a lot of people whenever on a confined space for periods of time, and you need to protect yourself. And right now, the vaccination is the key aspect of our efforts to stem the pandemic.
The desperation to get another shot comes as the Delta variant surges across the country. Hospitalizations now at their highest level in 6 months. More than 17,000 ICU beds in use across the country, and multiple states requesting federal help, including Louisiana, where critical care nurse Mary Lubrano delayed getting the vaccine until she recovered from surgery and radiation for breast cancer.
You don't want to end up this way. This is the scariest I've ever been in my whole life. You take breathing for granted.
Mississippi warning its hospital system could fail within a week, now asking the government to send the USNS Comfort Ship, the floating hospital that docked in New York City at the height of the pandemic. And here in Florida, where the Strategic National Stockpile deployed 200 ventilators earlier this week, doctors say patients are much younger, getting sick at a more rapid rate, and staying on ventilators longer.
This is the second major surge. This surge is actually much bigger than anything that we have seen before.
38-year-old Ian Woods, who's been in the hospital since last week, says he was waiting to get the vaccine, but this morning he's urging others not to wait.
Just go ahead and get it. It's worth it. I mean, I wish I had gotten it. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have wound up in the hospital like this.
And the CDC is now urging pregnant women to get vaccinated, pointing to growing evidence that the vaccine poses no increased risk for miscarriage and no safety concerns for pregnant women or their babies. Amy?
Victor, thank you. Joining us now is Dr. Anthony Fauci. Dr. Fauci, thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
So we know now that the FDA is expected to authorize those booster shots for people who have compromised immune systems. Do we know exactly who is eligible for the shot? Can you walk us through that?
Yes, I mean, the FDA will come out with the final determination, but it almost certainly will be, for example, people who have transplantation and who are on immunosuppressive drugs for that, people on therapy for cancer chemotherapy, people with advanced HIV disease, and people who are receiving immune suppressive therapy for a variety of diseases, such as autoimmune diseases. You know, that actually encompasses a relatively small proportion of the population. Around 3% or so of people would fall into that category.
And so there are a lot of people who are now asking, is this just the first step towards authorizing a third shot, a booster shot for everyone?
Well, what we need to do is to realize that you have to follow people, which we're doing in real time, namely a non-immune compromised, either an elderly person or a younger person, and follow them in real time, like every few weeks to a month, to determine if their level of protection goes below a critical level. And if and when it does, and it's likely that it will, because no vaccine is going to last forever, we're going to be ready and have a plan to be able to give those individuals the additional dose that they might need.
All right, so likely in the future, we all will be getting that booster shot. A lot of people already wondering, would you have to stay with the same shot you got initially? So if you were a Moderna, you had to get a Moderna booster shot. Have we figured that out yet?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the strong recommendation would be to stay with the shot that you have originally gotten. But we're doing studies now, which are mix and match studies, to sort of show that it is unlikely that there's going to be a problem going from one to the other.
Dr. Fauci, you've been talking about it. We've been reporting on it. There is so much fear about where we are headed with this variant that we're all dealing with, the Delta variant. It's believed we could reach up to 33,000 new COVID hospitalizations by Labor Day. That's four times where we are right now. Do you believe those predictions will in fact come true? And if so, where are we headed?
Well, you know, predictions really can be modified by what you do in response to them. And that's the reason why you see myself and many of my colleagues out there talking about why it is so important to get those 93 million people who are eligible to be vaccinated who are not vaccinated. We have a solution to this problem. So there are a lot of things we can do to not allow this acceleration of cases to just keep going up in a very sharp inflection. We have the capability and the power to stop that. We just have to act on it. And the first step in that is get vaccinated.
And speaking of those who are unvaccinated, we know that there is a relatively low amount of pregnant women who have been vaccinated. And the CDC now issuing new guidelines for those pregnant women, now recommending a vaccine. A lot of people are concerned, of course, about the safety of doing so. Talk to the pregnant women out there and let them know what the right choice is.
Well, the right choice is to get vaccinated without a doubt. We have experience with tens of thousands of pregnant women right now, and there's no safety signal of any concern. And that's the reason why the recommendation that pregnant women should or could get vaccinated, nothing against it, or should get vaccinated. Right now, the recommendation is that they should get vaccinated.
All right, Dr. Anthony Fauci, we certainly appreciate your time this morning. Thank you.